Maarten van der Spek, you are Global Head of Strategy at BNP Paribas REIM. Thank you for joining us on BiTV.
Yep, thank you. Thank you very much for the invitation.
In its new report, A Lighthouse Outlook for European Real Estate, BNP Paribas REIM reports a positive outlook for the European real estate sector. As the year begins, what leads you to such optimism for 2022?
Yeah, I'm actually glad we're very optimistic in this kind of environment with all the COVID situation. But yeah. No, we're absolutely positive on real estate, and there are like a number of key factors in that. So one, we are in this economic rebound. So we had this nasty period where we have a big economic decline, right? And we are now in the process of rebounding on recovering from that. Even though, because of all the COVID, now the Omicron, there are some like ups and downs. Nevertheless, we are in this phase of improving and rebounding, recovering from that crisis. Mm-hmm. So economic growth is the one factor that is really pushing and helping rental growth going forward, right? So that's one. On top of that, we have inflation. It's a lot higher than initially everybody expected. Especially given all of the supply chain issues, and we might have more supply chain issues coming because China could be more in lockdown situation because of the COVID. So inflation is not over and is here, is going to be higher for a number of years. So this year and probably next year before it kind of declines, but it will stay relatively high towards above 2% or around 2%, which is relative to like the last 10 years or so. It's pretty high. But as long as it's not out of control, which we believe it will not be, it's actually not a bad thing for real assets like real estate with indexation in the rent. So we have this economic growth, which is a positive driver for rental growth. Then we have inflation, which is helping indexation going forward for rents. And then finally, the bond yields, right? So bond yields typically respond to inflation. At the moment, they do, but not at the same degree, at the same level. So bond yields are increasing, but are expected to stay low for still quite some longer period. Okay. And as long as the bond yields are low, what we see is that the yields on real estate relative to the bond yields, that spread is really high at the moment. And so there's plenty of buffer for real estate. Actually, there's enough buffer to probably push yields a little bit lower even. Okay. And this in this environment, basically what you see is that large institutional investors, they are confronted with the situation that their bond portfolio is actually trading at a negative real interest rate. So what they're really keen on is actually investing in real assets, whether it's real estate or maybe some other assets like infrastructure. But that is something that helps them to create this positive real interest rate. And that's what they need, a positive income relative to inflation. And that's why real estate at the moment, I think, is really well placed.
Okay. And you talk about the investors' intention and the keen interest for real assets. What sectors do you think property investors should be looking for if they are looking for interesting opportunities? What sectors should they keep an eye on?
Yeah. I think there's some interesting elements in each of the sectors. The one sector that we really believe at the moment is probably best placed is healthcare, which is kind of a niche type sector. Mm-hmm. But the benefit of healthcare at the moment is that the yields are relatively high still. The rents are pretty stable, and typically they move somewhere with inflation up. So, which is a very good combination, right? High yields with some inflation indexation. And because of the high yields, we actually anticipate some yield compression as well, which makes return for healthcare industry pretty solid. On top of that, if you think fundamentally, demographics is a really, really strong driver for the long-term growth for this sector, whereas there's a lot of demand going forward, right? But the supply hasn't been completely institutionalized yet. So there's a push for more pressure on the market. So that's one of the sectors that we really believe in. Logistics is kind of like the main topic for the last couple of years. We still believe that in the next few years, returns will be really good, really solid. But we see some moderation going forward because of the at some point the yields are really low at some point, so they will stabilize, which means that the returns will be slightly lower. But I think the more interesting one at the moment is more on retail warehouses or retail parks. So retail has been struggling for quite some time, but one part subsector within retail that has done pretty well, and especially during COVID really well, is the retail park, retail warehouses, where the yields at the moment are relatively high. Rents are pretty stable. They weren't that much impacted during COVID. And actually, some of the retailers on these locations, these typically outside of the city center, very relatively cheap locations, actually some of those retailers did really well during COVID, right? So rents have done really well, and the outlook is pretty stable rents, but with really relatively high yield. So there's some yield compression, makes the return pretty solid going forward.
Okay, and geographically, are some markets better positioned to benefit from the recovery, do you think?
Yes. So I want to highlight two big ones, actually. So Germany is doing pretty good. Economic growth last year was actually disappointing because of the supply chain issues. Mm-hmm. But we expect that to kind of recover and be stronger this year. Real estate market, however, were positioned really healthy, and the growth in the real estate market was really good. So rental growth was really strong. So from a growth perspective, Germany is doing really well. However, on a yield perspective, yields are among the lowest, if not the lowest in Europe. So yeah, the combination makes solid returns not the best returns. Where we actually see the best returns is in the UK. We actually believe that the UK is going to outperform continental Europe, mainly driven by the two, by logistics and offices. Where actually since Brexit, basically, they have been underperforming continental Europe quite some time, quite strongly. Mm-hmm. So the relative performance was really weak in the UK. We actually believe that the Brexit, even though there's still issues with Brexit, especially in the UK, they have probably a little bit more supply chain issues and because of Brexit, and also they are lack of employment, right? Truck drivers, for instance.
Yes.
So there's some issues to cover and to solve because of Brexit in the UK. However, we believe that in the office market, the biggest pain is already priced in. And the relative pricing, UK versus continent, is actually pretty interesting. So where we expect the highest return for the next 5 years on average is going to be the UK.
Great. Well, thank you, Maarten van der Spek. Thank you very much for your insight. Sadly, this is all the time we have. Thank you all for joining us, and see you soon on BiTV.
Thank you very much.